Bloodstained Curse of the Moon for the Nintendo Switch. This is the second stream I make on this game because today I'm going back into it with the intent of finishing the game in Nightmare mode. I can't guarantee that I will finish it in one sitting like I did yesterday in normal difficulty. But I'll certainly try. Yeah, I did try it out a little bit off stream, just the first level. Well, no, I got to the boss of the second level, I think. Yeah, okay, Nightmare and Veteran. Let's go. Let's try this.
What was that?
At Journey's End, Zangetsu protected his allies at the cost of succumbing to the darkness in order to stop him. His allies venture forth once more. They may have to take their allies' life, but can they still save a soul? Apparently there's multiple endings, but I'm not quite sure what the requirements are, so just getting through that difficulty level, I think, is gonna be enough for me. I love the music in this game. Not quite sure what's up there, so I'm just gonna check. Yeah, that's not quite what I expected. Yeah, that was a mistake. Ow! Cramp. That's not quite what I wanted either. Yeah, that's gonna be fun. No reach whatsoever with most of these guys. So that was here then. Interesting. Yeah, because I never got it when I first played through this, since I could not reach that point. Because I didn't have a... Oh, what's his name again? Gable? Something like that. Alucard. To run out just as I was passing by. And obviously I don't have the lady, so I can't go that way. Come on, shoot. That's right. don't like that power, and I keep getting it regardless. That duplication kind of a magic that he has. Should have just flown up. I didn't think. Gained an extra life. Excellent. All right. We're in business. Mm-hmm. Up or down? Ow! Should have frozen it. Stupid. Not doing too bad. It's only the first few stages though. Pardon me. What I already have. Ow. Okay. Well, that's two upgrades in two stages. I think I might get all of them this time. That's it. Go ahead, do it one more time. Yeah. Okay. They're all maxed out. I think that's it. I did jump, but that was too late. I was looking at the left side of the screen so that I would press the button as soon as it would appear at the left side of the screen, but even then, that was too late, I suppose. Or maybe too early, actually. But anyway, the timing was off. Stage 3, the Brilliant Void. Is this one better? For this level? Nah. Oh, maybe it is. Actually, yes, I think, because there's these enemies crawling on the ceiling. Yeah. That's exactly the reason. Yeah, but I'm already out of weapon ammo. Yeah, that's the problem. It's all well and good having the right weapon for the job, but it consumes points. So what do I do here? Well, I guess I went that way before, and I think that worked. No, wait, Rudy. Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. For the best. Ooh. I hope I'm going the right way to get the upgrades. Because it would be a shame to miss out. Yeah, it works sometimes. Well, hey, Panda. How are you today? Holding up? Yesterday, yeah, on normal difficulty. But apparently there is another end to the story if you play this in nightmare mode, so I'm replaying through it. Ah, you haven't slept? Because you didn't want to, because you couldn't. Ah, there's the upgrade. Okay. Ah, you couldn't this time. Okay. That's not so good then. Boss time. Ah, stupid! Yeah, they do more damage to you. Yeah. As far as I can tell, they take the same amount of damage to defeat, but they deal more damage to you. And they have new attacks as well. The bosses are more nasty. I keep jumping too high with her. There! Good riddance! Ah, oh, that's not fair. I couldn't see what was happening because the screen was all blanked out. Well, I sort of have picked up some strategies here and there from watching other people's play. Like freezing a boss and then using the big axe to deal twice the amount of damage on them. It's actually multiplied by 4 if you're also moving towards the boss as you're using the axe. And this is the strongest sub-weapon in the game, so I'm kind of abusing it wherever I can. I'm definitely not as good at this as I am on Castlevania on the NES, for example, because I haven't played it nearly as much, having only beaten it once yesterday. They use that for speedruns, because I watched an AGDQ run some time ago, and I just remembered that they were using that strategy a lot. And they were speedrunning the game in Nightmare mode, actually, so I guess I can apply a bit of that here. I haven't really studied how they do it for everything, so I'm gonna use what I did pick up. Like, information in advance, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. No, I don't have to, no. But I do pick up sub-weapon ammo by doing so. And sub-weapon ammo, you can only carry a certain maximum of it, unlike Castlevania, where it's basically limited to 99. Here, you have a hard limit. Here, it's 30, for example, and they consume a lot of weapon points. So you don't want to be like anywhere below the max when you're starting a boss fight. Oh no. No, 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 no. No, it's like in Castlevania. You don't have to hit every candlestick. Sometimes there's health pickups in them. Also, so if you're a bit low on health, it's always a good idea to break as many as you can. Well, here I'm already maxed out, but also for points, because you can gain extra lives from us. Getting points. Using the right character from the job is also very important. I don't necessarily always think about it, because this is not something that you can typically do in Castlevania in general. Well, Castlevania 3 might be the only exception. Because you could play with two characters at the same time and switch in between. Although they would share the same health bar though, which is different from here. Let's go that way. Now this is very reminiscent of Castlevania. Except it would be dropping hunchbacks instead of toads. And I applied the exact same strategy, and it works the same. Which way? Not quite sure. I haven't obtained the health upgrade or whatever it is that you get in this one. Haven't found it yet. Well, you could probably get through the game without it, but it would obviously be harder. I'm not sure I need the game to be any harder than it's probably gonna be, being it that it's called the Nightmare Mode. Ah, there it is, the upgrade. Okay. An upgrade to weapon points capacity. I'm gonna let that thing disappear. Ah! I should have given that to that Alucard wannabe. Boss time. Yeah, that one's gonna be easy now. Ah, too early. Ah, I'm out of weapon points. I don't remember how to avoid it, that one. Oh, you don't get an extra life, I guess. Yeah, no, not on that one. That one has to be different, I think. Because they all have a desperation move. Right as they die, and if you can avoid it, if you can survive it without getting hit, then you gain an extra life automatically. Yeah, they don't even give you back your weapon points in between levels, so you have to start building up your supply all over again. Arrgh! I lost a character. I should have first taken care of that enemy. I didn't expect the hitbox of its projectile to be quite so high. Ah, yeah, I can't go that way now. What do I do? Do I die on purpose? Because I think to get the health upgrade or whatever it is that you get in this level, it's that way. But if I do get to the boss without having found the upgrade along the way, I might have to restart the level. You don't have to, you don't need it, but it's obviously best to have it. If you get caught by the painting, you lose your character. It's taken straight from Castlevania Dracula X, Rondo of Blood. Because that was an enemy in that game. That did that. Yeah, huh. I'm not gonna get the upgrade, I think. So you have a thing called the using this ability will return you to previous stages you have cleared. Yeah, I know. Just the beginning of that one would be nice. After reversing time, you cannot return. Items obtained since the chosen point will be lost, and stages will be uncleared. Yes, I want to. I'm gonna restart that level from the beginning. The only annoying thing now is that I don't have the ice magic, for example. Oh, well, okay, I got it back. I got lucky. As far as I'm aware, there is one upgrade per stage. Ideally, you want them all. Well, you can't get an extra life. It's gonna consume weapon points, but a lot of weapon points. That's the axe. Excellent. Well, I'm back here and I still don't have the upgrade. Not quite sure where it is. That way. Ah, there's the upgrade. Excellent. All right, then. I feel better now. Knowing I haven't missed anything major. Oh, you know what? Nah, I'm not interested in going that way. We might be at the boss already. Oh, no, not yet. Yeah, because I remember that screen. No, not taking any risks going that way. I'm already maxed out the weapon points, so... Okay, boss time. Thank you. It's not dead already, is it? I think it is. Well, I'm not getting an extra life on this. Oh, yeah, okay, it's dead. Yeah, that strategy with the ice and the axe works brilliantly against that boss. It was even easier than I had an easier time of it than I did when I played on normal difficulty, if anything. There is an upgrade. I suppose I already have what I came for in this level, then, I guess. No. Ah, don't die on me, stream. No, don't die on me. Fuck's sake. Why? Okay, so what do I do? I'm hoping it will go back to normal. Fucking internet connection. This was going well too. I'm gonna get disconnected.